Hello, my name is Terry Dean, and this is another edition of Solon Speaks. Our featured guest today is Don Holub, who is the Director of Recreation and Grantwood for the City of Solon. Don, I want to thank you for taking time this morning and spend a little time in informing the community of what's going on here at Grantwood and also in the Recreation Department. The nice thing is we're here at Grantwood. There's a lot of activity this morning. It's early in the morning. The best thing is I'm looking outside at a beautiful sunny day.
You're right.
Which, after a spring that we've had, this is such a nice thing just to look outside and see sunshine and nice green lawn. So this is a good thing. So I hope the people of Solon, will get over here to Grantwood and be able to use this beautiful facility.
Absolutely.
Before we get into some of the specifics, tell us just a little bit about yourself. I know you're a longtime resident of Solon. You've worked for the city for a long time. How's the family doing? We kind of update people once a year.
It's been great. It's actually a treat to be over here at Grantwood. My family, we're doing really well. My daughter now is in high school, which is a treat in itself.
She got a driver's license yet?
She's got her temporary.
So okay, so you're
Mom doesn't
that.
Do a lot of driving with her. Dad does.
So I see.
How that goes. But my son's in fifth grade at Orchard, and we enjoy the Solon schools, and that's another show, but that's a great opportunity for the people in Solon, obviously.
Oh, good. Let's talk a little bit about Grantwood itself. Over the last couple of years now, Grantwood has gotten a lot of focus. There's been a lot of improvements here. You've come over and taken over. Tell us a little bit about the facility itself. It's not just a golf course. There's also banquet facilities and things like that.
Correct. Kind of like the community center itself, Grantwood, we like to think that we do it all here. Maybe not quite all, but we do have a beautiful banquet facility. We've tried to, the area that we're in here, we tried to renovate in the past year. We've done some things to try to make it a little bit more family oriented. Mm-hmm. We want to bring people out here to Grantwood to enjoy themselves. And if they're going out there to golf, great. If they're going out there on the driving range, that's great also. But we want to keep them around and stick around with us for a little while and be here and enjoy the facilities.
All right, that sounds good. As I said earlier, we're sitting here, I guess I'm not sure if this is the lobby exactly, basically the gathering area.
Right.
We're sitting in front of the pro shop. There's a snack bar behind me. So there's a lot here that the people can use when they golf.
Mm-hmm.
Very friendly atmosphere, so that's very nice. As you said, they have banquet facilities. If a person wanted to use the banquet facilities, who would they contact?
They would contact Leslie Sobey. She's the administrative assistant here. She's in charge of both the banquets and the snack bar also. We like to say that Leslie does it all here. She's kind of like the, she'll probably kill me for saying this, but the mother hen, if you will.
Okay, that's always good.
She makes sure the Grantwood ticks, and she's done an excellent job. I really have grown to like her and really admire the work that she does, because she does a lot.
Okay, sounds good. Tell us a little bit about the Grantwood golf course itself. In other words, like, what are the hours? Obviously, spring has finally sprung, mm-hmm. as I said earlier, the rain. But tell us a little bit about the hours. Who can use Grantwood?
Mm-hmm.
A little bit about the golf course itself, some of the improvements that have made. I know you have a driving range.
Correct.
Tell us a little bit about that.
The improvements actually started about 8 years ago. They actually did the driving range, a new driving range. They had a smaller driving range that did not work. We've had a lot of changes over the years, probably the past 8 or 9 years, that have helped to change the image of Grantwood, trying to become more of a family-oriented, a practice facility. It is an 18-hole golf course still. We still have 18 holes. A couple of holes did change during that renovation, so they went through a period of change, but it's worked very, very well for us. We're trying to continue that. We want to become a learning, teaching center. And everything we do is kind of geared toward that. So all the improvements here are designed for the family. We want families to feel welcome here, men, women, and children. We want people to enjoy coming out here, have a great experience. It's not a country club. That's the first thing. It is a public course. Anybody is welcome here. There are no dues. There's no, each time you play, you're going to pay. But, we don't have dues or anything like that. So.
Now, are the fees here at Grantwood to play golf, are they competitive with the other courses in the area?
Yeah, actually, when I started last year, there was actually, appointed by the mayor, we had a three-person committee who actually came in and did a study to see how our rates compared with other rates, what we did, how everything compared to other facilities, kind of gave us some suggestions on how we could handle ourselves better here at Grantwood. And we've tried to implement as many of those as we could in the first year, and as we go on, we'll implement even more. And one of the things was the rates. They checked all the rates of the, if you want to call them the competing courses. And we are actually very, very, we actually lowered rates last year. And we kept them the same this year. And we want to make sure that we are competitive and that, you know, you don't want to be overpriced or underpriced.
Right.
You know,
right.
And we're a very competitive golf course, and I think people will find that.
Yeah, and as you said, the goal is to be, as with all recreation programs in Solon, is to be family-friendly and encourage
Absolutely.
Family activity
Absolutely.
And so forth. Now, I understand there have been a couple of changes. I think it's generally known that Scott Pollock has left Grantwood and has gone on to another career, or I believe selling golf equipment for another company. Has that affected Grantwood, or have we replaced Scott, or how does that fit into the picture?
No, we haven't replaced Scott as of yet. We wanted to reposition ourselves, and what we figured we would do is wait through the summer, and if we do end up hiring a new head pro, that would take place in the fall. Scott started a lot of things for us. He was a part of a lot of the changes and actually got us going on a path that I think that will do Grantwood very, very well.
Okay.
He did take another position with Callaway. Matter of fact, I see him not as much, but he's here, you know, probably once a week.
Oh, okay.
So we do see a lot of him, and you know, he's open if he has any comments or if we have any questions of him, he's there for us. So, and again, a lot of the programs that he put in place, we're just continuing. So.
All right, sounds good. You talked about some of the new programs earlier. What are some of the new programs that you've instituted here at Grantwood for the 2011 season?
First of all, we've actually started, what we're trying to do is do two programs a month, one that would be adult-oriented, another that would be family-oriented. One of the first programs that we thought of was a Moonlight Golf. We used to do it here a lot. We actually ran that through recreation a few years back, and we felt that, you know, that's something that we could bring back. There is a couples league, I think, for the first time in a few years. We're going to run that on Saturday nights. Along with that, we'll have some special events that will take place with that couples league. We actually are starting this year through the teaching portion of it, actually our two assistant pros actually are going to go to the high schools in the area and try to get either a high school league or at least a competition going between all the high schools here, something that we can garner some interest from the high school players also. We want to try to get all age groups involved.
Okay. Now, I have to ask you, what's Moonlight Golf? Do you come out here at midnight and try to play golf? I
mean, not quite midnight, but we do wait until it's dark. Usually we start about 9:30 at night. And what they do is they hit little glow balls that go probably about 80% of the distance of a regular golf ball.
Okay.
And the glow stick, you could actually see it go down the fairway in the golf ball.
Mm-hmm.
All the players are signified with, they've got either a glow stick around their neck or, and actually that's what you're hitting toward. You're hitting toward glow sticks that are on the tees, actually not on the tees, but on the greens.
Okay.
We mark the greens with glow sticks, we mark the holes with glow sticks, so.
Right.
Everything's in the dark.
Now, is this a family type of thing, or is this
an adult
thing?
No, it's more of an adult thing.
All right, so this is more for the over 21 crowd.
Absolutely.
Okay,
absolutely.
All right. It sounds like fun. It sounds like a little
it
different.
It is. It can be a blast.
Now, you talked a little bit earlier about, as we said, you know, the family approach to recreation and obviously using the facility here at Grantwood. Is there, like, if I was a mom and my 14-year-old, for example, wanted to learn how to play golf, could they come here and take lessons? Is there like a minimum age that you find that golfers kind of start?
No, actually,
I've heard them at, you know, like 5 years old.
Tiger Woods,
I heard them older.
The Tiger Woods story, right? No, we have a matter of fact. Carrie Bonham runs a clinic. There's actually two types of lessons that you can take. You can take private lessons, which I wouldn't really suggest for somebody that was that young for a 3-4 year old. But Carrie Bonham actually runs a couple clinics where he's got. 3-5-year-old kids, you know, 4 or 5 of them together. Those clinics actually run very well. You know, obviously you're going to start at the basics and go from there. But we have clinics for all age groups too. We also have summer camps that are going to be coming up, you know, as school gets out. We run summer camps all summer long. And it's the same thing. It's just for the people that are a little bit more, the kids that are a little bit more advanced.
Okay. And once again, who would they call in order to enroll?
They would call the pro shop here at 248-4646.
Okay.
And I believe it's extension 1. And, you know, they can just ask, the person that answers the phone will be very knowledgeable about the different lessons and the different programs that we run here.
Okay, that sounds good too. If you were a group and you wanted to learn how to play golf or something along, can you accommodate a group lesson?
Absolutely,
also?
Absolutely. Okay. Whether it's an adult or children, we can accommodate groups. Again, that's something that, again, we could either do it through one of our boilerplate programs that we have going right now, or if you wanted something special, we actually have our assistant pros sometimes go out with groups that come out that golf. Nobody has clubs. We have rental clubs in here that really haven't golfed too much before.
Okay.
And they'll go out and give them a couple lessons. That's not a problem.
All right.
As a group.
So if you're a person who doesn't play a lot of golf but would like to learn, you can come here and learn.
Don't be intimidated by it. You know, come out here and learn, and we'll help you out as much as we can.
Okay.
Definitely.
All right. Could you improve my golf score? Because I don't know. I haven't golfed in a long time.
I've got to work on my own first.
Okay.
You know, everybody thought my score was going to get better, and it hasn't yet. So.
Yeah, because you've got to run the place. You don't get a chance to go out there and actually use
exactly.
the facility sometimes.
Exactly.
We also, around here, I noticed we're looking out east here on Aurora Road, mm-hmm. and we're looking from the lobby here. There's a driving range, and I know that was installed a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us a little bit about the driving range? Now, I've noticed that when I drive by, sometimes in the evening, the lights are on. What are the hours for the driving range? Is there a cost involved?
Sure.
How do you use the driving range?
Obviously, the driving range is based on the number of balls that you're going to use. You know, we have four different baskets. The smallest basket, I believe, has 20 balls in it, and it's available. We call it our warm-up basket. It's available for $3. Or you can go all the way to 300 golf balls. That's a lot of swings,
mm-hmm.
For $25. So,
I think that'd give you sore arms.
I'll bet it would. I've never tried that, and I probably won't. But the driving range is open daily. The only time that we do close it is Tuesday mornings for just some fix-ups and, try to make it look pretty.
Some basic maintenance. Yeah.
Exactly. During the summer, it's open until 10 o'clock at night, and that's why we have the lights on. The wintertime, the hours do diminish, based on the sunlight, and the activity is a little less, too. That's one of the things that we've talked about is we may end up in January and February closing that down just because we don't get the use of it, and it's almost a waste of money to have the lights on.
Yes.
That's something that we'll look at it this year. It's available every day. And to be honest with you, that has been the saving grace here for the past 2 months. We've had the
really?
The wettest April on record, and I heard it was the second wettest May. So,
mm-hmm.
While people couldn't get out and play a lot of golf, at least they could get out there on the driving range.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Now, when they use the driving range, how do they pay for it? Do they come to the pro shop? Is there a way of paying for it out there? How do they?
Yeah, they can do it both ways. They can actually come in and pay for it at the pro shop, and we take cash or credit card.
Okay.
And also, the nice thing is, if we are closed, if the pro shop is closed, you can go right out there to the driving range, and it's the same thing. It does take a credit card and also cash.
Okay. So it's very easy to use. If you bring your own clubs,
easily accessible,
and
absolutely.
You want to stand out of the rain, you can use it even in a rainy day. And if you want to use it on a sunny day, you can use it on a sunny day.
Yeah, we're one of the few that obviously has a closed, what they call the closed tee boxes.
Mm-hmm.
So we have 15 of those that actually, if it's raining, you can still go out there and hit. Especially these past couple months, we have the mats,
mm-hmm.
Which we've had to be on really for the last couple months, where a lot of different courses actually close their ranges. We were able to keep ours open just because of the mats. So they weren't hitting off the grass. Now, during the summertime today, we're hitting off the grass. So
mm-hmm.
You kind of have your choice here, which okay. is a nice thing.
And it gives you a little more experience and a couple of different ways of hitting the ball.
Absolutely.
And learning swings and your style and
absolutely.
So forth. Well, once again, a beautiful facility. I notice I'm looking behind us here, and we have I believe you call this the pro shop.
This is a pro shop.
That shows you what I know about golfing.
Yeah,
this is
go.
The pro shop. Tell us a little bit about the pro shop. So if I came here, could I buy golf clubs? Could I buy a shirt?
Sure.
Could you buy golf shoes? Obviously, you run kind of the operation out here to pay for the course.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit about the pro shop.
The pro shop is really an amenity for the golfers here. It almost is like a quick pickup if... for the most part, if you've forgotten something, maybe you forgot your socks, maybe you forgot tees or balls or something like that, and it does happen a lot. People can pick that up right away. It's also an area where your professionals, the people who are in the golf industry, can actually help you. Decide on clothing, decide on shoes, things like that. One of the things that happened over the past year was that it actually was owned and operated by Scott Pollock in the past. It was his business. While it was here at Grantwood, the city had nothing to do with the pro shop.
Mm-hmm.
The city has taken over the pro shop this year. It's the city's business. And so we did remodel it a little bit, try to make it a little bit more, a little brighter.
A little stylish,
area.
Okay.
Opened up a couple windows that have been closed in over there. And we're getting generally good feedback on that. So. And yes, you can. It runs a gamut. You can go anywhere from golf clubs to golf balls, tees, shoe repair, things like that. We actually do some club repair in there. Mm-hmm. Just about do it all.
All right. So if you're a golfer, this is a full service facility. Then.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
All right. So now I want to play golf. All right. So first of all, who do I call? I want to set up an appointment.
You just call Grantwood right here. Call the pro shop. We actually do all of our business out of there.
Okay.
It's 248-4646.
Okay.
And actually, you'll be prompted to the pro shop.
Okay.
And you can set a tee time, or you can just walk on the course. You walk onto the course, and it's just like this at any other course. You run the risk of there's leagues that might be going on. So it's better to call ahead to make sure that the course is open, that you can come and play.
All right. So let's talk about that for a second.
Sure.
I would think that Saturday and Sunday would be the most popular day to play golf.
Absolutely.
So what time in the morning do you open?
We actually, on weekends, we open earlier. Depending on the weather, depending on, sometimes you have fog, sometimes you have frost.
Mm-hmm.
Usually we try to open around 6 o'clock.
Okay.
For the weekends. I think the first tee time is 6:30.
Okay.
So we're ready for the golfers early. Now, again, that's weather dependent. And as you go, earlier in the spring, later in the fall, those times will change a little bit. They'll go a little bit later.
Okay.
But summertime, weekday hours are a little bit later. We start about 7 o'clock.
All right. So now I would think Saturday and Sunday are busy, and you can start about 6:30 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And this shows you what I know about golf,
mm-hmm.
which is not a lot. Is the normal like a foursome or a twosome? I mean, you can't have 15 people trying to tee off all at once. It won't work. So how do you, is like a foursome the most you want?
I've seen people try that, though.
Is that right? Okay. Don't they call it a shotgun start or something?
That's
like
really
that?
A shotgun.
Okay. So if they start with no more than four people, do you try to space it like every 5 minutes apart or every group, like every
normally
10 minutes?
Normally every 10 minutes.
How do you do that?
We set tee times every 10 minutes.
Okay.
And yes, foursomes are the best thing. Very rarely will you allow, especially early in the morning on Saturday and Sunday, fivesomes. But if you know the people and they're very quick players, which we've had some here at Grantwood, as long as you know the player, and that's why you have, a lot of times, that's why you have a pro, because they know the players, they know how well they play and how quickly they play.
Mm-hmm.
You want to keep the pace of play going at a pretty good clip. Usually you try to play 9 holes in about 2.25 hours.
Okay, now that would mean then that Monday through Friday, when people are usually working, there are probably mm-hmm. less people on the course. Do you still open up at 6:30 in the morning?
We open about 7 then.
All right, about 7.
Mm-hmm.
Now, same thing, you would call for an appointment and you space them every few minutes apart and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
If I play golf during between Monday and Friday, do I get a little better rate because I'm not holding up the weekend people?
Absolutely,
or?
Absolutely.
How do you handle that?
We do have weekend rates generally are about $5 more than what you're going to pay on a weekday. That's for an 18-hole round.
Okay.
And that's, you're right, that's all based on the demand of play. We do have leagues on Monday through Friday. As a matter of fact, we have a senior league that played out here today. The golf industry has been down in the past couple of years. What we've noticed this year, and it's kind of been unfortunate because of the weather, we haven't seen it as much, but most of our leagues actually improved their numbers this year,
okay.
which was kind of a surprise for us, but a good thing.
So let's talk about leagues now. So if I'm a corporation here in Solon and I want to form a league, or if I'm a group of people and I want to form
mm-hmm.
a league, once again, you would contact the pro shop and say, this
Correct.
Is our league and we'd like to play at a certain time?
We'd look for the days that are open. Our after-work leagues, right now we have a great league that plays on Thursday
mm-hmm.
and Friday. I think our Friday league's been around for over 50 years,
mm-hmm.
Sugarland Valley League. Our TGA, it's called Thursday Golf Association, has been there almost as long,
mm-hmm.
and they're very well-established leagues. But we do have leagues even that play alongside. If they're playing 1-9, then you have a league on the other 9, which might be a little bit smaller. But, you could either, A, join a league that's already in progress, or start your own league. There's not a problem either way. And we would fit you into the time slot that you needed and that we could accommodate, definitely.
Now, I've noticed many times companies during the summer will have what I know is a golf outing, and you'll be invited to the golf
mm-hmm.
outing. Can Grantwood accommodate golf outings?
Matter of fact, and I heard this before I got here, but I'm really seeing it now that Grantwood actually does golf outings very, very well.
Okay, good.
The course is, it's a challenging course, but it's the way it plays, there's not a lot of woods, not a lot of areas that you're going to really lose a ball,
mm-hmm.
Except with the rough as we go through right now.
Okay.
But Seriously, it's actually a very, very good course for outings. And if you were going to do an outing, you would probably contact Leslie Sobey. She handles that terrifically. We've got a lot of outings that have been here for the past 20, 25 years.
Okay.
And a lot of that, I think, goes to her because she handles the people well and makes sure that you're accommodated. People enjoy their day.
All right, that sounds good. So once again, it's a full-service facility, mm-hmm. and it can accommodate a lot of different ways
Absolutely.
Of playing golf, and people can enjoy themselves. Dan, let's talk a little bit about you. You took this job a couple years ago,
mm-hmm.
and you know, at the time, Grantwood was a little bit under fire because they had borrowed money and had to pay it back, and there's a lot of things going mm-hmm. on, and the decision was made to kind of meld it all in with the city. You took over. There's obviously been some vast improvements here. You've done a great job. How's the second year going now that you made it through like the first year, and now you're into the second year? How do you feel about the whole thing? How do you see Grantwood going in the future?
You know, it's actually the great thing is it's a challenge every day. Mm-hmm. You know, first of all, I love coming over here. You know, what it's done for me is I think I've grown as a person. You know, not that I was getting stale in recreation because I still love recreation, but you know, it gave me a challenge to do something else, to try something else. And I got to tell you, nothing could have been done without the people. You know, I talked about Leslie. Dave Peck is a wonderful groundskeeper. You know, the people in the pro shop. Everybody here at Grantwood loves to come to work, mm-hmm. and I think you'll see that on their faces. And it was the one thing that really surprised me. You know, you heard. You know, again, you heard all the rumors that, you know, that went through the city. I didn't find a lot of that. You know, I found that people loved coming to work here. They really enjoy and actually put their heart and soul into this place. You know, and it's catchy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I caught on. You know, I love this place. And you know, it's home now. Doesn't make the job any easier. You know, you ask, has it gotten easier? No. You know, this summer, I think, was even more of a challenge. And I think as I go into it, as we go in further, it'll get more and more challenging. You know, that we still have a lot of work ahead of us, but we want to make sure that we are a family-friendly place, and that we want to make sure that our city fathers are done proud.
All right.
Absolutely.
That sounds good. And it definitely, the word on the street is it definitely has turned the corner and vast improvements, mm-hmm. so that's encouraging. I'm kind of having fun interviewing you because I'm looking outside and there's about 10 golf carts running around mm-hmm. here and people are doing things. It certainly is a beehive of activity, which is good.
You picked a great day to be here.
Yeah,
it's perfect today.
Picked the sunny day.
Yeah.
And the good news is that people are using it, and that certainly we want people, you know, to be encouraged to mm-hmm. use it. As you said, the prices seem to be reasonable,
mm-hmm.
And certainly when somebody calls Leslie, they can get, you know, the cost for golf outings
Correct.
And,
Correct.
You know, the day-to-day mm-hmm. play and so forth. The golfing industry, golf courses in general, and we have a few of them around here, as you said earlier, are facing some financial challenges.
Absolutely.
They all are.
Mm-hmm.
Grantwood's no difference. What do you see as the challenges in both in the industry and for Grantwood in the next few years?
You know, the unfortunate part is I think it's economy driven. You know, if people are doing well, they have some money to spend. You know, they love to go out and golf. You know, people that play golf are hooked on golf. They mm-hmm. love to play. You know, the
I've
question
noticed
is,
that, yes.
Yeah. You know, and it's just a question of whether they have the funds, mm-hmm. you know, the extra funds to spend on golf. And unfortunately, the last couple of years, that hasn't happened.
Mm-hmm.
We actually, play again last year was down a little bit. The way we actually improved was we cut our expenses. And I think that's what the golf industry needs to see is that, you know, in order to make it, you're going to have to cut your expenses. And I almost see this period as a kind of a riding out. You know, the stronger courses are going to be able to survive. In the 90s, there were so many new courses built. The unfortunate part, I think, right now is you see a lot of country clubs that are you know, you used to have the country club golf and you had the public golf.
Yeah, municipal golf courses.
And if you'll notice, most of the country clubs now are opening it up to, it's a great opportunity for a lot of people
yeah.
to go out there and play some of the country clubs out there
mm-hmm.
At a pretty good rate
mm-hmm.
Because they have to survive.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think it's good for the industry that everybody survives. You know, I don't see other courses as competition.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I want them to survive because I love the game of golf.
Sure.
And I love to go to, you know, I don't just play here at Grantwood. I play most of my golf at Grantwood, but I don't play just at Grantwood. And I think you'll find that most golfers are like that, that they love to play different courses. And, you know, the more options we have, the better it is for everybody.
Yeah, I would believe that an avid golfer would want to try different courses for the different challenges.
Absolutely.
Just to say they did it and also improve the game.
Sure.
So that I think I agree with you. I would encourage them to try different golf courses. Mm-hmm. Of course, we like to come here more
please,
often.
Yeah, please, come here very often.
Gentlemen, like anything to drink?
No.
I think we're fine, thank you.
Thanks.
See, and there's the superior service
there
around
go.
Here. Somebody came up to us and said we'd like something to drink, and that's great. But as you said earlier, that also shows the friendly people at Grantwood who are trying to encourage, family fun throughout the whole recreation
right.
department.
Right.
So, all right, let me ask you a question. I'm done playing golf. It's a pretty warm day. It's mm-hmm. 90 degrees. Do you have a snack bar?
Yes, we do.
Can I get a Coke?
You can get a Coke, you can get a beer, you can get a cup of coffee, hamburgers. Actually, we have some of the best burgers around.
Okay.
I can attest to that. My stomach can attest to that.
Okay.
But yeah, it's actually a full-service snack bar, either chilled or heated foods.
Mm-hmm.
We actually even have a deep fryer in there.
Okay.
Probably not the right thing to say in this day and age, but yeah, we do.
But it's there. That's
it's
true.
There.
Okay.
You know, we can go the gamut on the snack bar. We
okay.
have everything for you.
All right. Price is pretty much reasonable.
Absolutely.
Competitive
absolutely.
With other snack bars.
First thing that we did, we came in and we lowered some prices.
Okay.
We wanted to make sure that we were competitive in the market, and kind of looked at the prices other people were charging and made sure that we were very, very competitive. So.
All right. So you're in line with everybody else.
Sure.
You talked a little bit earlier about the Moonlight Golf, which I thought mm-hmm. was intriguing. What other programs do you have? Maybe another specific thing you have planned for?
Well, actually, for the month of June, actually June 12th, we are going to have a grand reopening of the Pro Shop, kind of like the new face of Grantwood. Want people to come in here, enjoy it. We'll have some prizes, some giveaways. Hopefully, we'll have some club representatives out there. You want to try a new club or different things like that. Want to make sure that people have a chance to come in here, even if you're not a golfer, come here and see what we did here at Grantwood and enjoy the day.
Okay.
We'll probably have a Father's Day special. You know, that's coming up in about 3 weeks, so we'll do something for our fathers and make sure they're coming out and enjoying their day with us. And
anything for July 4th special or anything like that?
We always run a special. It's actually a busy day here at Grantwood. You know, the whole weekend, actually, July 4th is a very, very good weekend.
Yeah, because that'll be Saturday, Sunday, Monday this
right.
year.
What we're trying to do is, and we don't have them all finalized yet, all those special events, but we're going to try father-son tournament, you know, mother-daughter tournaments, things like that, even family tournaments. Probably do some kind of an end-of-the-season scramble mm-hmm. that we can get a lot of people involved in and go from there.
All right, that sounds good. July 4th, as we said, coming up, that'll be a Saturday, Sunday, Monday. You're still working
correct.
On some programs for that. That should be a pretty busy weekend, I would think.
Yeah, well, let's hope the weather.
Yes, absolutely. Let's hope the weather cooperates.
Absolutely.
Now, since July 4th comes on a Monday, is that the weekday rate, or is that going to be a special rate? Or?
It's actually called the weekend holiday rate.
Okay.
So it is a holiday. There's always a special rate for the holidays, again, because it is a busier day, and there will be a lot of people out here playing, definitely.
Okay.
And I would suggest that if you plan on playing out here that weekend, that you get a tee time very, very early.
Okay, so you would encourage them to at least maybe a week to 2 weeks for the July
absolutely.
4th weekend to give a call and
right.
you know get a tee time set up.
Right. Especially the way it's been going this year. You know, one of the things that, because people haven't had a lot of chances to golf,
mm-hmm.
as soon as you get a bright, bright, sunny day, you know, people just want to get out, you know, take off of work and get here. So, you know, the worse the weather got, we saw that, you know, people, even if it was a halfway decent day, were coming out,
mm-hmm.
you know, so...
And
I use that term loosely when I say halfway decent day, because we haven't had many of them.
No, yes. And that's for sure. This is a municipal golf course owned by the City of Solon or operated by the City of Solon.
Correct.
Now, if I lived in Bedford, could I come and play golf here?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a muni course, but it's open to, when we say the public, it's all public.
All right.
Correct.
Do the Solon residents get a little better rate than the outside people, or is it all pretty much the same?
Believe it or not, Terry, and that was done actually before I got here. They actually did away with that rate.
Okay.
And really what it did is it created more headaches than anything else.
Okay.
If you were a Solon resident, you came in and you said you were a Solon resident, they didn't recognize you in the pro shop, but you didn't have your license, which does happen a lot.
Sure.
You know, you were angry because you're a resident,
right.
you didn't get the better rate.
Right.
You know, what we did is we lowered the rates, made them cheaper for everybody, and said, you know what, let's just do this, and so that we're not getting into that. Believe it or not, there were a lot of headaches in there, and you know, you would actually, even being a resident, would go away feeling bad,
right.
and we felt bad about it.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to show some kind of proof there that you are a resident, and it just wasn't working as well as I think it originally was planned.
Okay, and that's fine, and it makes sense. If you could, And I doubt if the rate was that much different anyhow, so...
It was a $1 or $2 difference, I think.
Yeah, so it wasn't a make-or-break issue.
Right.
And as you said, better to have a happy customer and playing golf
Absolutely.
Than walk away unhappy.
So we lowered it for everybody.
All right, well, that sounds good. Any closing remarks about Grantwood?
You know what? To me, it's a very special course. You know, obviously, it was one of the first city-owned golf courses in the Cleveland area. You know, the other ones I like to call copycat courses. You know, Hudson ended up buying a golf course. Stowe has a golf course. Twinsburg has a golf course now. Solon's had Grantwood for, it's probably been about 40 years now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we're still tweaking what we're doing, but I think it's a very, very good thing for a city. It's a jewel, you know, and it's not just the golf course. You know, there's other things that are involved with it. There's the 300 acres, you know, that the city bought when they bought Grantwood Golf Course that are, you know, pristine, that you can go out and hike through.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of different things for people that they may not even realize that are either A, here, or, you know, it's better than having a housing development on 350 acres. You know, that's something we all talk about. It's green space, you know,
yes.
And that's much needed.
Definitely green space, and green space in the heart of the city, which makes it really nice. You know, a lot of big cities, they wish they had green space.
Absolutely.
Here in Solon, we're fortunate that we have this much green space in this area. And it's off a major highway, so you can get to it mm-hmm. easily, and it's very pretty and certainly well maintained. Don, once again, I want to thank you for taking time out of your busy day.
Thank you, Terry. If
somebody wants to play golf, what's the phone number to call?
248-4646.
All right. Well, let's hope to a little drier weather, the proper amount of water from the skies when we need it, but not too much when we don't need it.
Absolutely.
And, you know, do a good summer of golfing. My name is Terry Dean, and this was another edition of Solon Speaks.